You know, it was much more terrifying, right? You know, Robin Williams just did an absolutely brilliant, memorable, nostalgic job in this film. So for me, when I'm looking at a role, and especially something that has historical nostalgic value to it, I'm asking myself, is there any meat left on the bone? What is it that I would add to the role? And one of the major aspects was going from animation to live action. So the idea that it was going to be live action, I was like, okay, that's going to be different. The idea of being able to modernize, to be able to pay homage to the original character and to be able to honor Robin while at the same time giving a new voice to modernize the genie. I saw that there was potential for absolute tragedy, but there was potential to be able to create something that did both of those things. You know, I love what Mina did is Aladdin has a little edge. Like, Aladdin, you know, it's like Mina made Aladdin cool. You know, Aladdin is, he's got a little roughness around the edges. He's you know, not perfectly crystal clean. And it was fun to see the Aladdin brought in and humanized in that way. There's a really strong emotion that Mina's able to capture of struggle with Aladdin that I like. So the first meeting is in the Cave of Wonders, and Jafar knows that because his heart isn't pure, he would never be able to get the lamp. So he's sending Aladdin in to get the lamp to just see if Aladdin's heart is pure. So Aladdin goes in, and of course his heart was pure enough to get in, and Aladdin rubs the lamp. So the genie's first impression of Aladdin is, oh, it's clearly not you. You know, he looks at Aladdin. Aladdin really isn't impressive enough to have found the lamp and rubbed the lamp. So he's like, where, you know, he wants to know, where's your boss? Where's the, you know, who's really in charge? And Aladdin makes it clear, no, it's just me. I'm the one that's in here. I'm the only one that's here. So I guess the first impression the genie has of Aladdin is thoroughly unimpressed. Yeah, the Prince Ali parade is probably one of the signature pieces of the piece, and the combination of practical and CGI, it really was an extravaganza. You know, it's hundreds of extras on multiple levels, and animals and costumes and stunts and singing and dancing, and the way that it was shot and the way it was captured, and it's you know, I'm excited to sit in an audience when that happens. So yeah, one of the new ideas for Princess Jasmine was her desire to lead the people of Agrabah. She has an opinion and a perspective on how it should be led, and you know, it's a modern take on the character that I think will be welcomed by the audience. And I think Naomi had a very clear position on how she wanted to deliver that, and you know, I think it will go over well. I think it's a good addition. I was delighted after our first meeting. We talked. It took me about 10 minutes. I was like, okay, yes, I'm in. You know, he's between action and music, and then his character concentration. It was just very different from what I was thinking about for a Disney movie. But he delivered something that is really unique, and it's clever, and it's fun, and it's funny in a different way. Yeah, I'm very proud of what he's done.